Hi, welcome to the North Peninsula Democratic Club's Candidates Forum. We're now going to be meeting two candidates for the Jefferson Union High School District Governing Board, Andrew Lee and Kalimah Salahuddin, correct?
Salahuddin.
Welcome.
Yes.
And the format, we will have each candidate will give an opening statement. There will then be three questions that have been provided by the forum, an opportunity for a one-minute answer, as well as a 45-second rebuttals if necessary. And then we'll have questions from the audience, should there be any, and then there'll be a closing statement. And so with that, we'll begin with Kalimah to begin with your opening one-minute statement, and welcome on behalf of the club.
Thank you. Thank you for having us. Again, my name is Kalimah Salahuddin. I am incumbent. I'm running for my seat again for the Jefferson Union High School District. Education is my passion. As a youth, as a child, and especially in high school, I got off track. And it was the school system and a counselor at the school who reached out to me and believed in me when I didn't believe in myself and put me back on track so I'm able to sit here before everyone today. And now, with this current state of education in California, I wonder if that counselor would be available to me if I were to walk into the school system now. We need to make sure that we have an affordable, equitable education for all our children in this district and in the county, and I'm here to work to do that.
All right, thank you very much. Andrew Lee,
you're yes. Right. My name is Andrew Lee. I'm an appointed incumbent of the Jefferson Union High School District. I was appointed last November. And one of the things for me, actually, I'm a current parent in the district. My son is a sophomore in the district, and my daughter is a recent graduate, graduated back in May. And I have seen what our schools can do for my kids and what I've seen them do for their classmates. And it's really just humbling for me to be able to be a part of the process to educate the students in our district. There's well over 4,000 students, and it's just great to be one of the decision makers with my fellow board colleagues to be able to set vision and direction for a school district that is really doing some amazing things, and we're on the verge of doing even greater things over these next few years.
Great, thank you. All right, we have three questions. We'll start with Andrew, and then Kalimah will chime in, and then she'll get the second question to start. So the first question from the forum is, please share your thoughts on how the Jefferson High School District can work to close the achievement gap for lower income students and for students of color?
Great question. I think for me, it really begins with retaining our teachers. We've experienced a high number of turnover over the years with our staff. And I think that as we can find creative solutions to keep our teachers, we're not paying them, the salary schedule is not particularly competitive relative to other districts in the county. And so for us to find creative solutions, which may mean looking at workforce housing to be able to keep our teachers and finding them an affordable place to live, those are the types of solutions I think we're going to need. Because if we can retain the teachers that these students have created work relationships with, we'll be able to help close that gap.
Great. Kalimah?
Sure. So I think that the naming of it needs to be reframed a little bit from achievement to opportunity. A lot of our students, especially students of color or low income, don't have the access to the opportunities that other students have. Summer programs, trips abroad, after school programs. You know, a lot of parents send their kids to tutoring and other things after school that if you're low income, you don't have access to, or that the parent may need that child to work so they don't have the time to take the SAT prep, do all these things that students or parents do for their children who come from more affluent backgrounds. Another thing that we do need to talk about in schools that we don't talk about, that's talked about other places, is race and how we approach students. And that a lot of our teachers do not look like the students that they teach. and so therefore have a hard time identifying and may come with a bias that they are not aware of. So we need to really talk about unintentional bias. How are we approaching students? Do we understand them and meet them where they're at? And are we able to, not coming from their background?
Rebuttals from you?
No.
Okay. Unconscious cultural clashes, one of my major issues. All right, question number two, Kalima. The Jefferson High School District gave its teachers their first raise in 5 years back in 2013. How do you feel about giving teacher raises again during the next round of union negotiations?
So I think it's vital. Before I became a board member, I worked on the successful parcel tax. I was the campaign manager, which allowed the district to give the raise. And that's why I worked on the parcel tax. We unfortunately are the lowest funded high school district in San Mateo County. So we are 20 minutes away from two districts, one that has double the per pupil salary than we do. So, and our teachers want to be with us. They want to work there and they're accepting a lower salary, but we can only push that so far. We have to be able to pay them enough so they can live here. It's extremely challenging to live in this area. I know for myself in my job where I make more than a teacher and I struggle. So we can't have teachers in the classroom worrying about how they're gonna pay their rent, buy their groceries. So I am more than willing, if every dollar that we can afford to send towards teacher salary, I am willing to do that.
All right, Andrew?
My thoughts are actually very similar, pretty much. I think we simply need to look at the totality of our budget and find places where we're maybe inefficiently spending money and find ways to direct more of that to the teachers. We're looking at having an auditor come in to audit all of our books and to see if there's something we may have missed. We've actually just hired a new CBO. We'll start in a couple of weeks. And I think that process of having a new chief business official as well as going through an audit will help us actually identify what else we can give the teachers and really how much more. I think the fact that we do have some raises coming up in this coming year for them that we've negotiated, and you know, what more can we give them is really the question we need to ask.
All right, rebuttal.
I will just say that there's only so much that we can do as a district, and the passage of Prop 30 and the continuation of Prop 55, that is the beginning of the path, that is not the end. And that we as Californians really need to look at our investment in education, that even with this current investment, we are still around the 30th per pupil in the nation, and that is not where we belong. We are one of the richest places on earth. Our students deserve much better than what we're giving them.
Okay. Chief business officials are paid more than superintendents of some districts in
yes.
California. They're that much in demand, and it's hard to keep them when they come. All right, the third question, and Andrew, you get to start this, is what distinguishes you from your opponents?
Well, I think, actually, I think what's funny is that with both Kalima and I actually have a lot of similarities just in the way we approach education and the way we approach governing on this board. It's actually fun to serve on this board with a friend. Kalima is a good friend of mine. And so it's just great to be able to share a lot of thoughts of when we're sitting up on the board. We actually just simply have a lot of fun as we listen to the items being discussed and presented before us. And oftentimes I find that one of us is actually saying exactly the thing that the other was thinking. So it's not so much differences as it is a lot of similarities in the way we approach working together on this board and governing this district.
All right.
So again, we are all running, we want to stay together as a unit. Our board is very functional. We went through a very tough year in re-upping our parcel tax. At the same time, we hired our new superintendent. And that really brought us together as a team. And a functional board is hard to find in California and is something to be cherished. And we are very functional. We get along. We are different. We bring different backgrounds, but we understand our common purpose. We are here for the children. And sometimes adults, especially in education, we get in each other's way and we forget our main goal is to make sure that our children receive the education that they deserve. And it's really nice to work with board members that all understand that and get that. And so I would like to keep our team together.
Okay, rebuttals?
No, just full agreement with what my colleague just said.
First time I've heard a school board member say they have fun at the school board. All right, now it's the opportunity for the people in the audience to ask any questions should they have some.
My question is, how do you feel about the suspension and expulsion issues that all schools have right now, and how would you like to see it get better?
All right, we'll start with Kalimah.
So again, our district in particular has an ongoing issue with suspension expulsions, especially with significant subgroups, African-American boys in particular. And again, one of the things that first came up was we were suspending a lot for clothes and for boys sagging their pants. And if you come on a school campus, there is no race that sags their pants more than any other, but we're noticing it more in particular kids. And so again, we need to make an environment to where we're comfortable to having these conversations, because the way we approach certain students may be different depending on the background that we have, and it's not malicious and it's not intentful, but it's happening because the data shows it. So we need to really look at it and provide an environment so we can have those real conversations to address the problem.
Andrew?
I think I concur. Actually, a lot of it, it's actually just creating a school environment where the teachers, staff, and students actually understand the differences and the backgrounds that they all have, and coming to a common understanding. I mean, one of the benefits my daughter had when she went on sojourn to the past, which is a civil rights trip to the South. And for my daughter, who was half white and half Asian, to experience what it was to be in the Deep South and what these men and women had to go through in the 60s really opened up her eyes. And it empowered her to empower her classmates. So when she came back, she would call out students who were using the N-word and who were saying very inappropriate things just because these students didn't know any better. But she was empowered to educate other students. And we need to create more opportunities for our students to be able to experience that type of thing.
Rebuttals?
One of the things that I am pushing for and we're looking at is to see if we can have sensitivity training for all of our teachers, starting with our VPAs and moving down within our system. And another thing is to teach, it's also within the classroom, and as Andy said, having more opportunities for our kids to learn about all of our histories, not just certain particular histories. So expand our cultural exploration in all of our different curriculum so that there is a common understanding of who we all are as Americans.
Great. Sojourn, nothing's like it.
No, there isn't.
John Lewis is a hero to all of us. Second question.
I'm a council person here in Millbrae, and our rec center just burned down. And I come from a park and rec background. We don't have a good relationship in terms of sharing facilities with our high schools, and we have two here. What can we learn from you? Because I used to work in one of your high schools. What's your philosophy of working with local cities and local park and recreation areas? Because in sharing facilities, in making sure that we have a place for both our children and our adults.
Andrew.
Well, I serve on the 2x2 committee with the City of Pacifica, the Pacifica School District, and the North Coast County Water District. And so we discuss actually quarterly issues related to governance within Pacifica. And it's those types of conversations that actually allow us to be able to talk about shared facilities or other topics that may come up, for example, even with lead testing at our schools, where the Water District actually offered up to test Ocean and Terra Nova for free as a service to us. And so those discussions came out of those types of meetings. And so I think, to your point, it really is about us being involved in 2x2 committees with our local city councils. And in our case, we have to add in Daly City, in Brisbane, and Colma as well.
Kalima?
And I serve on the 2x2 for Daly City and Brisbane. And to piggyback on what Andy was saying, sustainable communities are healthy for children. And so we want to make sure that our communities are thriving. And the funding issue doesn't just affect school districts, it also affects our cities. Our cities are sometimes more underfunded than our schools are. So sharing resources, not duplicating services, it just makes sense. It's financially and fiscally is the smart thing to do. So we're very open as a board to making sure that our facilities, especially that are paid for with bond money and or paid for by the community, are as open as possible and as shared. And if we're open, our city has responded in time. Both all of our cities have responded in kind and have been equally open to sharing their resources with us when available.
Is something, can I ask a really quick follow-up?
They have a rebuttal.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Rebuttals?
No.
Follow-up?
Do you think the philosophy that you have and what you do up there help pass the parcel tax?
Absolutely. We had no one opposed. We had a huge support from our city councils. And if you look further down the peninsula, you know, there was a school district that went out for a parcel tax and the city council opposed it, which blew my mind. And we don't have that problem at all. We had our city council members campaigning for a parcel tax.
Great. Thank you.
All right, time for closing statement. I tell you both terrific answers. I mean, really, you're both well aware of the issues that face a lot of the North County revenue limit districts in terms of competing with basic aid districts, particularly at the high school level as you go further south. So with that, Andrew, you get to give the first closing statement.
Sure. Well, I'm just honored and humbled to be able to serve on this board and for the students of our district and for the parents of this district. You know, it's an exciting time now with our new superintendent on board. We have a new direction, there's new life, there's some excitement, there's hope. You know, I talk to teachers and they're really hopeful and excited about what changes, positive changes are coming down the road. I mean, we're a car that's sort of been remodeled a little bit, a new engine has been dropped in, some new sheet metal, you know, fresh coat of paint, and we're starting to rev the engines and go. And it's an exciting time. So, I just want to be a part of this ride for the next 4 years.
Great. Kalimah?
So, I'm extremely proud to be a part of the Jefferson Union High School District. All three of my children are here. They all went through the high school district at different schools and are in college now. And I want to make sure that we're a viable district for all the students that are coming up behind us. We've had a lot of trouble in the past, leadership, and I'm very blessed that I was able to have strong board members beside me, and we were able to do the work that needed to be done as a board to move the district in the right direction. And as Andy says, with our new superintendent and new administration, I'm really excited about the future, and I want to continue and see through what we started.
On behalf of the North Peninsula Democratic Club, congratulations to Jefferson, won a football game.
Yes.
Last night. Thank you for appearing, and endorsements will be forthcoming, I think, on Monday. So
thank you.
Thank you so much.